I was raised in a very heavy Judeo-Christian background in education. And I was programmed to believe about God and about Jesus and salvation. And
what were you programmed to believe?
If you don't accept Christ as your Savior, there is no salvation in the next life.
Well, now let's soften that so that it feels better to you.
Okay.
Interesting that in the room just now, Jerry pulled a Bible from the drawer and just opened it. And Jesus said, "Ask and it will be given." And Jerry said, "This sounds very familiar." And the next part said, "As you see it and believe it, it will be." And Jerry said, "That too sounds familiar." In other words, do not take this whole clump of anything and call it one thing or another. Sift through it and find that which resonates with the depths of that which you are. We were talking earlier about symbols, and someone was talking about the mantra of gum. And we say all religions and so many methodologies have found points of focus for you to focus upon. And so it was said that this was someone who was connected, so much so that he too was a healer. So why not use a symbol like that of someone tuned in, tapped in, turned on as something that you too are wanting to achieve? And we agree, people do sort of get carried away with the rhetoric. It's true of every religion. Religions gravitate so far from where they started. But there isn't anything wrong with you identifying the essence of that and holding unto it. We see many, many people in many different religions closing their vibrational gap. In other words, their life is causing them to want, and their religion causes them to believe. And so there is nothing wrong with religion, and there is nothing wrong with that religion. But guidance outside of you can never replace guidance within you. And in fact, if you are really listening to what Jesus and so many others had to say, that was their dominant message. That kingdom of heaven that you are seeking is within. Now, we don't know how they got to the place that they're at. In other words, we agree that there are a whole lot of people who profess that as their religion who are very far from being connected to source energy. You can tell that because they don't feel good. Anyone who is angry in their religion isn't living it.
Yes, I see.
But we don't want you to describe yourself as a recovering... because it gave you a platform, it gave you a basis, it gave you a place to start, it gave you an opportunity, it gave you a good basis, you see.
I see.
And now you're expanding from it, and that is good, and that is what all religions at the heart were teaching. It's an interesting thing to watch this movement of religions, because someone like Esther gets into a vibration where she can interpret from source, and then others hear it and like the sound of it and begin to write it down. And all of that is fine until they conclude that the religion can only go as far as those words were. When the whole point of an experience like this, and everyone that was at the heart of every religion that you know of, was interpreting in some way. In the early days of Esther and Jerry doing this work, they did a radio show in San Antonio. That's when they learned the true meaning of the Bible Belt. because the radio interviewer was not really having anything about them. How they ended up on the show is still a mystery to them. And the guest that was supposed to come before and the guest that was supposed to come after didn't show up, and so they had a very long dialogue with this man who really wasn't having any of them. And he had trained his audience, for the most part, to think like he did. And so the people who were calling in were really not very enthusiastic about Esther professing to be receiving from broader perspective. And so one woman was describing her outrage at what she was hearing. And when she stopped, we said to her, "And what is it that you use as your source of guidance?" And she said, "I use the Bible." And we said, "We have heard that it is a very good book," which annoyed her. And then we said to her, "And how is it that that book has come to be?" And she said, "It came from God." And we said, "And in what way was it translated or interpreted?" In other words, how did it get from God to paper? How did it get from God to words? Someone received it and interpreted it. And do you know that woman had never thought about that? She'd never thought about that. It had never occurred to her to think about that. All she knew for sure was that nobody ought to be now speaking from non-physical energy. Nobody ought to be professing that they speak from God, because God stopped speaking the day that book was finished. So now it turns out everybody's got a damn book, and they're all professing that it's the book. And then they kill each other because you've got the wrong book, you've got the wrong book, you've got the wrong book, you've got the wrong book. And we say, bury those books. Let them be. You all have access to source energy. And so if those books or any book inspires you to your understanding of who you really are, an extension of that which man calls God, and you let your life experience cause you to ask meaningful questions, which source energy will answer every single time, no exceptions, and you can somehow get yourself into vibrational alignment with that by working on your worthiness and working on your appreciation and working on your love and moving yourself up the emotional scale, you'll get so tuned in with that energy that you will never again question who you are. And those books, while they may be delightful, while they may inspire you in this way and this way, will never replace your true connection to source.
Thank you.